Today in this class we discuss the formula in the method, the statical formula. In this class we discuss about the statical formula. So last class we discussed the sum if formula and sum ifs formula, and today also repeated for that. It's like I want to sum here. You can use the formula sum formula. You have sum unit result, and you want to average formula, apply the average. You can average your quantity, and you want to count up the numbers, you can use the count formula. So we have some statical formula we have discussed one by one. First we repeat the sum if formula. So I want to sum, like Pooja, we use the sum if formula, and in the sum if we have select the first range and criteria and sum range. You can got the sum only for the Pooja. But you have the logical command, just like I want to greater than 50. I want to total of the quantity greater than 50. That time we use the also sum if formula. Sum if, you select the quantity column and give the quantity. So if you have the criteria range and sum range, both are the same, so no need to apply the sum range. But problem is that if we have the numbers, we have not a symbol of the greater than, less than. So we have, if we don't want to give the sample one by one like that. This is a very typical question, because we have the 20, 25, 100 and 200 number of the data. That time we have used the sum if formula, sum if, select here and comma, and in the inverted comma we have write the greater than, less than, both of the which you require symbol, and concave your numbers in the criteria sector. Then we have select the your sum range, press the enter. You can see here we have got it, we got the numbers here. What I want to, just like we have the Pooja and Pooja Singh, Pooja Kumar, but you can also use the start key. We have used the sum if here and range, criteria and sum range. So Pooja, this is the end with Pooja, this is the contain of the Pooja, and we have removed the first star, that is the start with Pooja. And we also give the question mark. It means any two character match in the C column, yeah, which you have your criteria column, you have sum. Select your character and totals. So any two characters, it's like GK is a two character, total GK, so any two characters. But we have the more than one condition. It's like I want to Leela in Delhi. More than one condition. Delhi and also waste, we have the three conditions. And also we have I want to greater than 50. We have the four conditions. That time we use the sum ifs formula. Sum ifs, select here the sum range, comma, criteria one range, criteria one, criteria two range, criteria two, criteria three range, and criteria three, and criteria four range, and criteria four. You can see here, your result will be here. But if you want to sum between two date periods, it's like I want to sum the Jan. But problem is here, if we have not a date, we have not a I want to generate. The first we have create the start date and end date of the Jan. So we have just used the concave here and conquer the 4th Jan and 2021. This is the 2021. We have missing the inverted comma here. Yeah, right. And we have used the eco month in the end of the month. So this formula we have calculated. Sorry, sir. Some distraction here. So that time we have used here sum ifs form. Select the sum range. Select the criteria one range. Give the criteria is the greater than 1st Jan. Second again date colon. I give the criteria second criteria less than equal to the 31st Jan. You can sum the month here. This formula and this formula you can also inbuilt in this sum if formula. So Mr. Krishnan, do you clear? Any doubts?
Yeah, clear.
Okay. So now we have used the average formula. So if you have the, we have the average formula. If you have the data here and you want to calculate the average, so we have the three formula of the average, three to four formula. The first formula is the average. Calculate the average. Average. Calculate the average. This formula, ignore the blanks and also ignore the true and false. But if you had applied the formula average A, this formula is ignore the blank also, but not ignore the true, because true is the one and he is the calculate the average according to one. Now do you want to average of particular conditions? That time we have used the average if. Average is the formula just like a sum formula. Select the range, select the criteria, select the sum range. Press enter, you can see them. So this is the average of Pooja. And in the average formula, you have also include this method. You can also use this method in the average formula just like a sum formula. But you have the multiple conditions, that time we have used the average ifs formula, just like a sum if formula, sum ifs formula. Average range, the criteria one range, criteria one, criteria two range, criteria two, criteria three range, criteria three, and criteria four range, criteria four. This is the average formula. Now, do you want to use the count? We have also the count formula. Just like count. First the count. Count numbers. Only for count number, ignore the blanks and ignore the text. But if you use the count A formula, count A formula, calculate the text and number, both are the same. Ignore the blanks. And next is the count blank formula. Count blank, just count the blank cell. How many blank cell? So this is the fixed condition. But do you want to count the particular conditions? According to the particular conditions, that time use the count if formula. And count if formula also discussed in the relookup class. So select the names and select the your criteria. You can count here. And in the counting formula, you can also include this method. But you have the multiple conditions, that time you use the count its formula, select the criteria, we can range criteria one by one. You can count the formula. Now we have the maximum formula. Use the max formula. Max formula is the max of your data. Maximum number of your data. And also min formula, minimum number of data. But we have the one formula, max A or min A. So max formula ignore the true and false, but max formula consider the true is the 1 and false is the 0. And same min A formula, min formula ignore the true and false, but min A formula include the true as a 0 and false, true as a 1 and false as a 0. But we want to calculate according to your conditions, that time we use the max if formula. Ifs. Max if formula select the max range, and this is the first is the criteria range, and select the criteria. You see the max. And you can also use the max multiple condition is the max A. Max if, sorry. Okay? So select the max range, the criteria 1 range, select the criteria 1, criteria 2, select the criteria 2, criteria 3, select the criteria 3, criteria 4, select the criteria 4, and you can get the result. The 90 is the maximum number. Mr. Krishnan, do you have any doubts? Now, if you use the max formula, so if you have used the max formula, give the maximum number. But I want to the top 5 number. I want to just top 5 number. Top 5 number. The top 1. The first is the 90. What is the second? What is the third? Fourth and fifth. That time we have used the formula large. Large formula, select the your colon, select the your numbers, and press the enter, you can get the first and the 19th. Then we have this drop and down here. You say second is the 38, 37, 37, and 34. And 37 is the repeated time, so we have give the repetitions. Right? And same minimum, if we have applied the min formula give the minimum value, that time we have used the a small select the data and select the your numbers. Please drop down here, you can say the your minimum value. But I want to rank, we have the 60, I want to rank. So what is the position of this table? 60, what is the position of this table? So we have used the rank formula. The rank, we have the rank average. You can also apply the rank do the according average, but rank is the main formula. The number, the reference, and order. Do you want to large ascending and descending? I just select the descending, then top number, reference. 60 is not available. So we have write the 60. Now this is the 15 number. So when you type the 15 here, you can with your large formula give the largest number as 60. And you have select the ascending, that is the this small according to give the according to small. Okay. So in the formula menu bar, we have used the statical formula. In the statical formula, have more of formula, but this formula depending the mathematical calculations, and this is not used in, mostly not used in the your data report automations. But you have just check out the formula list. If you have find the any important formula you have the required, then tell me. I give the class on this. But mostly formula we have discussed which formula commonly formula used in the report automations. Okay, so I request, so please do the practice on this.
Yeah,
and tomorrow we discuss the some questions about the semi formula.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, to meet tomorrow same time. Thank you.